The late Ennio Morricone, the greatest film composer of all time, has been making around 10, if not more, soundtracks almost every year from the early 1960s for about 5 decades straight, only slowing down in these last 10 years. Most people always list Morricone's greatest scores as being his spaghetti westerns, Once Upon a Time in America, Cinema Paradiso, and The Untouchables. Of course, this is absolutely true. However, I want to honor some of Morricone's incredible, underrated, and/or forgotten soundtracks that are just as good. Because of copyright purposes, I will only play the soundtracks that I chose for a few seconds, so I recommend to just watch these films if you have not already seen them, because they are truly amazing. Enjoy. Number 1. Grand Slam. This Giuliano Montaldo 60s caper is one of the greatest heist films of all time, and for me, one of my all-time favorite films. Morricone's score for this masterpiece is just as spectacular, and one huge reason that makes this film as good as it is. The maestro's score, which plays during the film's opening scene particularly, is simply incredible, and builds the excitement and thrills of the film to come. Number 2. Dario Argento's Animal Trilogy. Yes, I am cheating a bit here, but I just want to mention all three soundtracks to Argento's early giallos, which really don't get enough praise. Morricone's unique and innovative, spooky, and beautiful soundtracks are truly some of the greatest horror and thriller scores of all time, incorporating human breathing, unusual instruments, humming, and all kinds of odd sounds to emphasize the scary atmosphere of Argento's giallo classics, as well as breathtakingly beautiful music, makes these three Morricone scores not to be missed, particularly the love theme from Cat O' Nine Tails, Nina Nana in Blue, the incredible last scene of Four Flies on Grey Velvet, as well as the entire soundtrack of The Bird of the Crystal Plumage, being for me one of the greatest soundtracks of all time. Next we have The Master Touch. This Eurocrime heist action film starring Kirk Douglas has a score that is both melancholic and morbid, and at the same time, mind-blowingly beautiful, perfectly reflecting Michele Lupo's gritty, intense film. Here is a link to my review for this great film up on top now, or in the description below. Number 4. Lucio Fulci's Lizard in a Woman's Skin and Paolo Cavara's The Black Belly of the Tarantula. Two more incredible giallo soundtracks, yet different from those of Argento's. Lizard's theme, particularly the score that plays at the end of the picture, after the almost unsolvable mystery has finally been solved, is something that must be witnessed. And the Black Belly of the Tarantula theme is sinister, twisted, and super awesome. And last but not least, Brian De Palma's underrated great film, Casualties of War. The maestro teamed up with De Palma again after The Untouchables and composed one of his most powerful scores, a heartbreaking flute score, for this tragic heavy film, leaving the audience both in goosebumps and in utter awe. Something that seems like an easy feat for genius Ennio Morricone. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope I gave you some good recommendations, and let me know which Morricone scores you think are unjustly underappreciated, or what your favorite scores of the maestro are in general, and please share this video to help spread the memory of the master. Also, check out our video on the best Carl Reiner films that you've probably never seen. See you next time.